and random systems. Okay, these two tutorials will be not directly connected. Both are about new things. And what do I mean by finite time dynamics and finite time predictions? In chaos theory, nonlinear dynamics, always we are interested, as classics taught us, in asymptotic properties when time goes to infinity, or if it's discrete dynamics, number of iterations go to infinity, and what are, because it's really chaotic system, it's really chaotic dynamics, and what are the asymptotic properties? And all basic notions there, all defined in the limit when time goes to infinity. Lyapunov exponents, Kolmogorov entropy, many others, all integration over infinite time, again, limit 1 over t from 0 to t, okay, transport coefficients, many other things. Already today we saw it in the lectures. And, of course, in reality, and this is a physics conference, we are interested in finite time. What I will be going, yes, in the long run, we all are dead. This is what was said by one economist. Yes, not physicist, but I think all physicists agree. So, and you know, this finite time dynamics is a term that has been used because many people are talking about that. And for instance, people are talking about finite time Lyapunov exponents, which is actually a product of corresponding Jacobians, and their distribution in the phase space, right? What I'm going to talk about, it's totally different phenomena. It was very surprising for me. It took really a lot of time to understand better. I'm not sure I completely understand this because it's against our common wisdom. And also it is not wisdom, but knowledge, okay, however talked. Chaotic and random systems. Because chaotic dynamics, what is the major thing? That orbits behave like orbits of random processes. Therefore, let us use all the machinery of probability theory. So again, limit theorems of various types, starting with, of course, central limit theorem. So again, time goes to infinity. What I am going to consider as a major example, random, will be coin tossing. What it is, that we have symmetric coin, we flip it, and then with probability 1 over 2, we have head, and with probability 1 over 2, we have tail. Okay? So, in this audience, I also should say Ariel Andreshka. Okay, so what is complete analog of coin tossing? And there are many of them. And I will use here essentially only one example. Yes, everything that I'm going to talk about besides ideology is proven. Yes, therefore, I'm not going to formulate theorems. I will make some pictures showing how these theorems work, what are conditions. So just and complete analog, there are quite a few of them in dynamical systems, ergodic theory, is the following thing, which is called Dublin map. What is Dublin map? It is, again, simplest formula you can imagine. X goes to X modulus 1. So phase space is unit interval, 0, 1, 1, here 1 over 2. And here is a graph of this function, which is two parallel straight lines with slope 2. Therefore, you can immediately see that if you talk about finite time Lyapunov exponents, they're all the same in all points, right? Time is n, 2 in power n. So therefore, forget it. We are going to talk about something different. And, okay, I consider this partition. This corresponds to head. This corresponds to tail. But when we code orbits, we can write head, tail. But often we will write, of course, 1 and 0. Yes? And therefore, orbits are coded by zeros and ones. I see that some experts are unhappy because I'm talking about so trivial things. Okay. But hopefully something else will come soon. And what I'm going to do, I'm not going to predict what is going to happen in the next moment when you consider coin tossing, because it's probability 1 over 2 head and probability 1 over 2 tail. But let's consider the following thing that we always consider in dynamical systems, coding of these orbits. So it's partitioned into 4 elements, head, tail, head, and tail. So elements of this guy, it's from 0 up to 1 over 4, they all stay for 2 steps in the left-hand side, right? Those start in the left-hand side, left half, and for the first iteration, then go to the right, and so on and so forth, right? And problem that I'm going to consider, I will formulate in the following form. Suppose we have partition into 2 in power k elements. These elements are coded by, let me put still 0 ones, sequence of length k. And I pick 2 sequences of the same length. Results are also for different lengths, but again, it's tutorial. I will consider only this. So another one of length k. And we are playing game. One participant bets on this, another on that. And what is the bet? That this will show up the first, or this will show up the first, yes? And what I am going hope to convince you, that actually answer is exact. What to do at any moment of time. And that actually we can say that it's more likely that in the next moment of time, so just not on the final time, but even in the next moment, more likely one guy will show up than the another one. And of course, when one of these guys show up, then game stops. Of course, it is the same question about this map and many other maps of this type. Okay, so if we pick, say, this guy and this guy, yes, and start with unique, only reasonable physical invariant probability distribution, variant measure, which is length here, is easy to check. Okay, then at some times you need to bet for this, and some other times you need to bet for this, and this is precisely answered. Okay, so this is what I am going to talk about. Now, all these results are actually very surprising to me too, and how I run into that. I did not formulate problem. Let's make finite time predictions. Yes, it came from listening to talk by Nir Davidson. So there are two groups, Ryzen and Davidson, who performed very nice experiments with quantum billiards. So atoms were moving inside, so they can create any, well, papers, there are many papers, but two published in PRL, okay. And so they can create any shape, but how to measure what is going on? They scan lasers in order to create any shape. Then they made holes in the boundary and measured how many atoms escape through this hole, okay, in some time. So it is open dynamical systems. Yes? So, sorry? Well, atoms were moving there. So therefore, okay, it's, well, okay. So, yeah, okay. Very good to have just one mathematician, okay, in the audience, okay. And of course, I agree with you, so just, okay. So, because my knowledge, well, anyhow, so just. Okay, so atoms, right? But they made holes because, as I understand, you know, it's quantum measurement. If you put there measurable device, you're going to measure not dynamics, yes, of your system, but interaction with this device, because atoms are very small. Okay, so, and after his talk, okay, I asked, but dynamics should depend essentially the results on where you put a hole. You know, if you put it here, I expect something different, you know, whatever. And the answer was, yes, it varies widely. And then I ask, okay, but what you observed? Answer was, I don't know. And then it was, can you come up with a theory? Yes, this is, was kind of task. And what actually I'm going to talk about is the following. I'm not going to talk about open systems, even though it's completely related. I'm going to talk about closed systems because the idea which I got very soon was the following. Suppose you have closed system, yes? Then you can do the following. You can consider open system making holes, so copy of the same guy, in different places. And like spy on this system, yes? Knowing something about this open system, tell you about you can tell something about closed system. Okay, so now what are going to be major characteristics that I am going to look at? So we'll be talking about dynamics, about transport in the phase space of very chaotic systems. So where we consider some partition, like again, always think about these two, this one-dimensional Dublin map, or the same as, for instance, for tent map and many others. And we are going to compare, okay, dynamics with respect to different elements. In order to do it, I need to introduce several notions. So we have invariant measure mu, which is length, so just a very simple measure here. And so I have some element of this partition, which I will call h from hole, remembering that it was hole. Now it's not hole. And let me introduce, S h of n, which is going to be collection of all orbits such that t m x does not belong to h for all m less or equal than n and greater equal than 1. So this set consists of all orbits which survived which did not hit this hole. Yes, did not hit this upset. Therefore, okay, measure probability of this set is, of course, survival probability. We have heard about survival probability already today. Yes, this is exactly what a survival probability. Probability not to get there. Okay, now, of course, physicists were studying open systems much before than mathematicians started. And very natural notion to introduce is escape rate. In strongly chaotic systems, this survival probability, which I will call PH of n, behaves like exponent minus rho n. So, and rho, of course, is rate of survival, survival rate, okay? So, always, so it's escape rate. So rho of h is defined as limit, okay, when n goes to infinity minus logarithm p h n. So, okay, strongly chaotic. Well, I mean, that they are hyperbolic. Is it clear here? Yes? And moreover, they are uniformly hyperbolic, strongly uniformly hyperbolic. Distortion is zero. So slopes, right? Slopes are the same, right? So cannot be more strongly chaotic. This is why it's coin tossing, which is the most random system, right? Okay. So, therefore, question, natural question trying to answer this demand from Nir Davidson was, does this escape rate depends on position of a hole? Yes, and hole is finite. And this turned to be a new question in mathematical theory of open dynamical systems. This is when the first time I look at that. People did not consider it in mathematical theory, and the answer was that, yes, it could be holes of the same size in the system, and escape rate is different. This is a key question, yes? Now, how to answer this question, yes? How to find a hole where escape is going to be slower or faster? First of all, observe that. Yes. Yeah, it's always uniform. Simplest case. So I start with uniform distribution, right? Which is invariant measure. In numerical studies, again, people start with uniform distribution. So I don't want to go to this complication. So this is exactly what I'm considering. Okay? Oh, no, no, you mean this thing? Ah, no, here I will show you picture, hopefully, pictures and numerical experiments, which support that it was, it's not proven for that, but numerics show that it's all. No, 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 okay. Okay, so just at the end. The best answer is wait, okay. So, but observe for the moment that this escape rate, it's again characteristic of the same type. It includes in its definition limit when time goes to infinity, okay? So the first result that I want to mention, which was very surprising to me at least, actually to referees too, okay, was the following. I may use this thing now. So again, we consider, think about this doubling map, right? And result, well, all I will be talking about its rigorous results. It's with my student at that time, Yurchenko, which says that if we draw a picture, this is time, this is survival probability, and I pick two elements of the partition which are which have the same sides. And I will draw a curve. Even though it's discrete system, think about, say, linear interpolation between these points. Yes, because graph is going to be, yes, go ahead. But this exactly, yes. My initial condition, uniform distribution of measure. I'm talking about probabilities. It was exactly question, Ellis question. What? Yes. So then this is what is happening. Initially, these two guys have the same probability, right? So this survival probability goes down. And then they split. One goes like that. Another goes like that. And this was, it's about survival probabilities, okay? It's not about this limit. It's about these guys. So we can compare these guys. So before limit, okay? Moreover, it's possible to say what is going to be this moment of time when they split. They split and they will never intersect again. Okay? Sorry? Yeah, well, I pick two holes, of course. Yes, I don't want to put here 2^k curves, yes? So, result is either these two curves coincide because of some symmetry that I mentioned, or they split only once, and we can say exactly when they split. Okay? It corresponds to several holes. Well, because to symmetry, natural symmetry of left and right here, each curve corresponds at least to two. More questions? Split means that exactly this. That survival, blue survival probability is going to be larger than orange at any moment of time. And this is finite moment of time. This was actually very surprising. Yes, and I better tell story, I don't know, on dinner, whatever, but because I was shocked at this moment. I thought that in the proof there is something wrong because it's much more than I wanted to prove. Before N star, because they were the same, they had the same sides, yes? Another thing, just to make you more curious, is that actually I can look at subset of different sides, yes? And then natural intuition would be, well, through big hole, escape is always faster, yes? Answer is not, because, guys, and I think it is a really good explanation, and this is exactly the thing. Not only sides, but dynamics matters. Okay? So, but I will talk only about equal sizes, not to go into details. Yes? What? Dynamics. Okay, I turn to this right away, and it has to do with your question, and go ahead. Because this is result. Okay, so just here, size is the same, right? Okay? Okay, well, again, it was my mistake, forget different sizes, you know? Otherwise, I'll go, yes? What is? Periodic orbits. their probability is zero. Okay? And we are talking about probabilities. It's all probabilistic. What? For finite time, still probability of point is zero for finite at infinite time. Okay, more questions. What? Okay, I have two subsets here. One corresponds to this guy, and the same, another corresponds to this guy. Okay? It is survival probability curves. Survival probability is defined over there. Okay, I don't stop because it's not open systems, right? What I consider survival probability, probability of all orbits which did not hit this subset. Yes. Yeah. More questions? Okay. Yes. Now, okay, what is the next thing, okay, about that? So here you see we have finite time. Why this finite time is so important, and so on and so forth. Okay, when we have completely homogeneous situation. And here comes definition of very important characteristic, which was introduced. It's absolutely new for dynamical systems. It was introduced for John Conway long ago, okay? So when he was trying to answer exactly this probabilistic question, you have two sequences of heads and tails to which one you should bet in order to have higher probability, okay, to win, okay? So, and he, look, this question, his question is about average again, yes? Average over infinite time. But this is notion what he introduced there, which is called auto, actually correlation. Correlation of words. What is word? Word is exactly this sequence. Head, tail, head, head, and so on and so forth. Tail. This is word or code which codes any element of this partition. Okay? And if we have another code in any language, then we can introduce, let's call this omega 1, this word, and then we have omega sub 2. Okay, let me give you an example how it works. Correlation of omega 1 and omega 2. I will introduce it for different lengths of words, even though I will use it only for the same. So suppose we have English alphabet, and so, and we have two words, tomato and torus. Then, correlation of tomato with torus. How you compute it? How you introduce it? This is what you are doing. Okay, now let me move here again. Tomato. I need to write below second word, torus. And then what I do? I consider this part where under this guy there is this guy. And tomato is not torus. Therefore, I write zero. Then I move torus to the right. It's new notion for dynamical systems. Torus. And this part under this part. tomato is not torus. Again, I write zero. Yes? And so you see that this will continue. And as a result, I am going to have a word of zeros and ones, okay, which is of length 6 as tomato. Yes? It's going to be 4 zeros. But then the store comes under this store, and it will be 1. And then under this O will be T, 0 again. So this is correlation of tomato with torus. This is autocorrelation of words. Okay? So procedure which tells you that. Okay? So, and Conway derived very nice formula about answering his question. So, to which of these two sequences of head and tails one should bet in order, on average, to win? And answer is odds. Of omega 2 to win are going to be like that. Autocorrelation of omega 1 minus correlation of omega 1 times omega 2 over correlation omega 2 omega 2 minus correlation omega 2 omega 1. So here are the odds that W2 will win over W1. Okay? So this is definition. Who wants to hear this definition? It's okay. Who does not want? Okay. Two. But this is something that you can always compute. And all the theorems, all the results on finite time predictions will be about that. What we have here, that autocorrelation, so this is autocorrelation of word orange is greater than autocorrelation of word blue. And if you have this condition, then it's going to be like that. If these autocorrelations equal to each other, these two curves coincide. End of formulation of the first result. Look, what it tells me, this first result, that, well, survival for blue is going to be higher all the time, yes? But it's still not prediction, finite time prediction, tells you that after this moment, on infinite interval, yes, this guy will survive at any moment more. What? No. Actually, well, it's a long story. Actually, later. With Caperini or maybe Cachaça, go ahead. Understand? Definition? Definition. No, okay. The sizes are the same. And this is why they both started here. This is size of the hole. Yes? Survival probability at moment zero is size of the hole. Decay rates in which sense? Yes, they have different decay rates, yes. Right. No. Because they may have different decay rates. This is the most, to me at least, yes. Maybe you see it immediately, but I don't. I did not see it. Look, there are these two guys. One decays faster, another decays slower, but why there is only one intersection? Asymptotically, before that could be infinitely many intersections. Striking fact for me was that there is only one. We can say something about finite time. This is why I thought I have mistaken the proof. Because we all we are taught, we are teaching that, well, you should wait till infinity. Okay? So this is the thing, right? But look, this is still not finite time prediction. Okay? So it just says that in any moment of time, well, survival will be higher. And what is survival? We want probability to come there. And then what we are going to consider? We are going to consider a more delicate characteristic of this stuff. And I will mention two applications of this stuff, which I see for quantum systems. Okay, this I will erase. Everybody remembers that, I hope. So let now introduce first hitting probability. And what is first hitting probability? Instead of considering all the orbits which do not come till moment n, yes, I will consider only orbits, it's hitting, well, omega, okay, at the moment n. It is collection of all orbits such that TmX does not belong to H, okay, H omega, it's code for H subset, okay, for all m less than n greater or equal than 1, but TnX hits this guy. Okay? So, and therefore, probability of first hitting, okay, at the moment H, in moment n of this guy, is just measure of this subset, again, measure of all orbits which were waiting for time n and then hit at the moment n, right? And now, guys, observe such simple thing that these guys, these sets do not intersect. Because if one first hit at moment n, it means it did not hit at moment n minus 1 first time. Therefore, survivor probability P, yes, let me put it there, PS survival, HN is sum of first hitting probabilities, okay, hitting probabilities of HK, K from 1 up to okay, up to n. This is first hitting, up to n minus 1, right? Okay, these guys do not intersect, and look, I had result about this guy, survival, right? And so, therefore, what we have is, of course. So, survival, yes, it's sum of first hitting probabilities for all k from n plus 1 up to infinity, right? All that hit after that, yes? And they do not intersect. Again, this guy is infinite sum, yes? This is why I cannot predict there what is going on. But I now look at this first hitting probabilities. And this is what is going to happen. Now I want to switch it on. Is it possible? Okay, so, okay, where should I push? Probably here. And show you pictures. Uh-huh. Okay, very good. So look, here are pictures for tent map, which is absolutely analogous. So I have partition here, okay, and pick two elements of this partition. Then, which one? Okay. How to go to the next one? What? Oh, okay. So should I use, oh, this? I don't know, strange. Yeah. Yes, okay. Then let's take the this one, right? This one. Oh, yeah. Okay, so, and here is the corresponding picture for first hitting probabilities for these two subsets. Look what we have here. They intersect in only one point. In only one point they intersect, which means the following, that in this beautiful formula of Conway, yes, it is average over infinite time about odds. But what we have here at first time, to the best of my knowledge, something which tells you that there are two different intervals. One interval of short times, I call it, before they intersect, and then interval, infinite interval after they intersect. It's first hitting probability curves. It means, yes, it's different, right? But it's survival, yes. It's survival over there, but this is first hitting. It's more delicate. So instead of comparing two series, I compare each element of the series formally. And look what we see here. We see that there is only one intersection, and what should we do when we play? Yes? You can go to Canzino and try to do it. So just here, till this point of intersection, we should bet on this blue guy. Yes? Higher probability in any next moment. And here we should bet to another one. Yes? And what we usually have, always have, in dynamical systems, asymptotic of this, with things goes to infinity. This is new interval, yes, where prediction is totally opposite. Okay? And look, question is, okay, but how long is this short times interval? Here we have two subsets which are coded by four letters, zero ones. So length probability of each one is 1/16, right? And so time before intersection is about 20. So let's go on. And again, either such two curves intersect, coincide, or they intersect only once. Now consider all the ensemble, all the coarse graining. Not all, but many of them. And here we have already words of length 6. Yes? 2^6. And look what is happening. There is hierarchy of these guys on the interval of length 60-something. So much longer than it used before, right? Then they start to intersect. They have pairwise intersections, yes, on the intermediate interval. And then what comes here, it goes to infinity. Opposite hierarchy. Opposite. All we are looking at is opposite hierarchy in infinity. And question is, practical question, yes? First of all, for physicists, you know, who do experiments, computer experiments. Well, what does it mean that I consider longer these codes? It means that I explore my phase space with higher precision. What is happening to this new short times interval, yes? When this precision goes up, when you explore your phase space of your system better and better. So, unfortunately, well, we have
weaker results or just with the length of cord, it grows at least linearly. Numerics show that, it, as it should be, it's intuition, it goes exponentially. It means that if you want really to consider in details your dynamical system, yes? Okay, you need to look only on this short times interval. Okay, and what else I want to show you here? Not this. Okay, look, this is back to experiments, yes, where I started with. And this is what we consider numerically and why. It is diamond, but it's asymmetric diamond. Therefore, this distance, this diameter is less than this. And look what is happening when we do the same type of analysis. Okay? We take this part of phase space, well, and of course, it's Hamiltonian system, phase volume, measure probability, this part and this part. And you see, of course, with green, they split much better, its corner. But even these two guys, because of some intuition that we have about billiards, this is exactly what was predicted. This red guy, because this is shorter, is above blue guy, yes, but then they split. Yes? Of course, it's not the proof. And actually, we have more computer experiments. And for such, this is, of course, non-uniformly chaotic system, right? But there are quite long intervals where you have one more likely will be hit, another more likely will be hit. Again, don't go to infinity. Now, so this is what I wanted to show you. And now I want to mention two things about, well, which I believe there is very natural questions related, actually results, related to quantum description of the system. And this is what, of course, Felix wanted me, okay, several times. Say, look, guys, I was talking so far about this finite size subsets, right? And what is the difference between these two guys, yes, or these two guys that I had before, which split, right? Difference is, key thing is, if I take subset of my phase space, 0, 1, so here I have this blue interval, here I have orange interval, and periodic orbits are everywhere dense, yes? Therefore, key thing is, what are periodic orbits? Smallest periods, yes, which intersect these guys, yes? Because starting with some period, okay, all of them intersect. So, and here is the thing. Number one, which I believe has to do with proving that scars exist and even some physical explanation to that. And second, with Gutzwiller formula. Result is like that. Let now consider a point. Exactly what. Let's consider a point if my phase space, right? Escape rate through a point is zero, yes? Because probability to hit a point is zero, yes? Therefore, what I do, I take a point of my phase space and consider sequence of smaller and smaller neighborhoods. So here is going to be point and smaller neighborhoods, right? And so I take this neighborhood number n, un, and un contains un plus 1, and they shrink to this point. And so I consider the following thing. Escape rate through the small guy un, yes, which of course tends to 0 when n goes to infinity, yes, it's going to be point. Therefore, I do normalize it by the length, so measure of un, yes, And here is the result that was very surprising. And this, of course, is generalized, whatever, so just that limit when n goes to infinity depends on whether it's periodic or non-periodic point. It is one if x, this point x, is non-periodic. So this probability 1, this limit is 1. But if it is periodic, it's 1 minus 1 over 2 in power 2 in power p, if t px is x, if it's p periodic point. So at periodic points, escape slows down. Moreover, here are exact values. And what it means, look, scarce, yes? Something stays there for a long time, yes? And we see that, yes, in many of your computations. This is show that radiation out of the system near periodic point of small periods is less. Okay? And therefore, this is where you have scars. And stronger scars if these periods are smaller. Okay? This is number one. And second, if you remember, well, so I should not say in this audience, if you remember Gusswiller formula, I might not remember it. But this also some new interpretation, and it could be rewritten in this form of coefficient there. Okay? Because what is quantization of Gusswiller formula? Over periodic orbits in chaotic systems. Okay? So, these are two more messages that I wanted to tell you. And also mention that there are quite a few other things. This started about 10 years ago, on contrary to the things that I will be talking about later this week. So, but as I think Viktor Weisskopf said, it's better to uncover a little than cover a lot. I hope that a little I was trying at least. Thank you. This? Yes.